Everyone, my name is Karen Yagas and I will continue the discussion of Ma'am Janine Domondon. So the first one there is all about evaluation of general guidelines in grading tests or performance tests. So first one is, okay, to develop grading criteria, it is used in traditional tests and performance tests. Ito po yung ginagamit nilang criteria na kung saan para ma-clear po sa mga students yung mga grades nila. So, learners should always be informed of the weight of the criteria. So, dapat ini-inform po natin yung mga students natin dun sa criteria na binigay natin para maging aware sila kung saang part dapat nila tutukan yung gagawin nilang performance. Sinabi naman po nating inform learners what scoring methods. Ito po yung ito yung dapat bago po mag-start yung activity or performance sa pinapagawa ng teacher is dapat ini-inform po natin sila kung ano ba yung nilalaman ng criteria na ibibigay natin. So such instruction should be followed and applied consistently so every learners in the same class or other learners. Ayan, para maging fair po yung pagbibigay natin. And, fifth, decide on what type of test score to use. So, there are different ways by which student learners such as measured and presented. So, sa performance po is ginagamitan po yun ng can be measured and reported through row score. So, naka-row po siya. So, andun po makikita yung percentage na binigay ng teacher. So, dito po gagamitin yung criterion reference test and or norm reference test. So, importante po yung pagbibigay ng grading ayan, sa mga students na kung saan ginagamit po yun in different tests, assignment, and performance test. So, kailangan yung mga learners should also be informed at the start. So, bago mag-start, sinasabi na upang sa ganoon is magamit, kagamit-gamit at informative siya sa mga students. So, let's move on to the next. So, guidelines, general guidelines in grading essay test. So, essay requires more time to grade, more grades than the other type of traditional test. Ayan, so medyo mahirap at kakaiba po yung pagbibigay natin ng grades sa essay at saka maraming oras yung inilalaan natin dito. So, meron po tayong mga important na kailangan tandaan. So, the following general guideline scoring essay test. So, una po dyan is identify the criteria. Ibe! So, una po dyan is identify the criteria for rating the essay. Okay, so the criteria or standard for evaluating the essay should be predetermined. Ayan, so the criteria can be used. So, kailangan po yung criteria may content, may nakaayos po yung format niya, then yung grammar, proficiency, at saka andun po yung mga important details na nilalaman. Ayan, so, karaniwan pong binibigyan natin ng rubrics yung mga students is performance tasks, just like mga reporting, ayan, so mga skit, ayan po. And then the second is determine the type of rubric to use. Ayan, so may two types po ng rubrics, yun yung holistic and analytic. So, pag sinabi natin holistic rubrics required evaluating an essay, the essay and taking consideration all the criteria. So, ibig sabihin po, only single score is given. So, overall judgment na po yung binibigay when it comes to holistic rubrics. When it comes naman po sa analytic rubrics, so ito po yung ayan, so pag sinabi nating analytic score, ito po yung required essay and evaluating base of the criteria. So it's provide useful feedback, and doon po nakalagay learner strength and weaknesses nila. Ayan. 3, prefer the rubric. So yung rubrics po is kailangan doon yung skilled, yung competencies related to essay writing, dapat naka-identified po yun. And then, the skills and the competency presented in criteria. Dapat nakalagay po siya doon. So, ito po yung ginagamit nila. So, ayan po yung example. So, most frequently used are descriptive with corresponding rating skills. So, ayan, nakikita po natin yan yung points value. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, pag sinabi po natin 1, yung sample performance benchmark po niya is need to improve. So, beginning, kailangan pang improve. Ayan. And then number 2, satisfactory. And then 3, good. And 4, cutlery. Ayan. 4, evaluate essay anonymously. So pag sinabi nating evaluate essay anonymously, checking essay should be done in anonymously. It is important that the writer does not identify those paper she is rating. Ayan. And then 4, scores one essay question at a time. Ayan. So, one essay question. Siyempre, sa isang tanong, may isang essay. So, ensure that same thinking and standard are applied at for the learners in the class. Siyempre, kapag nagpagawa ka ng essay, dapat pangkalahatan po yun. Ayan. Hindi po iba-iba yung topic na binigay natin. And then, 6, be conscious of own biases with evaluating a paper. So, dito naman po, so, should not be affected by learner's handwriting and writing style, length of response. So, hindi po dapat siya, yung pagre-rate po natin, hindi dahil dun sa pangit yung sulat niya is 0 na agad yung score na no po. And then, yung writing style, so maybe may patumba, ganyan yung mga ibang style ng mga sulat ng students. And then, hindi naman porket mahaba yung essay niya is mataas na agad yung grade. So, hindi po ganon. Ayan. So, nakadepende pa rin po yun sa nilalaman ng essay na isinusulat ng ating mga students. And then, review initial scores and comments before giving the final grading. So, this is important especially for a essay that were initially given a barely passes or failing grade. So, yan, bago tayo mag-decide, so, kailangan i-review muna natin yung score. Saan ba yung students natin na kulang? Anong part ba? Yung kailangan niya pang i-improve bago natin siya bigyan ng comments and yung final rating. So, bago natin siya ibagsak, kailangan alamin muna natin yung mga nilalaman talaga nung essay niya kung karapat-dapat ba siyang ibagsak or may improvement pa na pwedeng gawin. Ayan, get sa 8, get 2 or more rater. Ayan, so sa essay, so we need a high stake. So, such as those used for administration, placement, or scholar screening purpose. So, sa final grades po nito, kailangan will be arranged average of the all rater given. So kung pwedeng gagamit ka ng 2 rubrics, pwedeng gagamit mo yung analytic and holistic, pero matrabaho na po siya. And then 9 is write comments. So next of the learner's response to provide feedback on how well one of perform is essay test. So dito importante na magbigay tayo ng feedback sa mga students para alam nila yung mga part na weakness nila and then yung strength na meron sila. Kung anong part nila dapat pag-improve pa. So, para alam pa po ng mga students natin kung saan nila i-improve yung gagawin nilang essay just like that. Okay, next, what is the new grading system of the Philippine K-12? Program. So on April 1, 2015, the Department of Education through DepEd Order number 8 series 2015, so they announced that the implementation of a new grading system for all grading levels in public school for elementary to senior high school, although the private schools are not required to implement the same, so they are the same guidelines. So they are encouraged to follow them and are permitted to modify them in accordance to their institution. Ayan. So, kahit private po sila, mapaprivate, kailangan pa rin nilang sumunod sa batas ng edukasyon. Ayan. So, here the grading system is described as a standard to find a specific base grading. So, competency grading system where 60 is the minimum grades needed to pass the learning area. So, which is transmuted to 75 in the report card. So, the lowest mark that can appear on the report card is 60 for quarterly grades and final grades. Ayan. So, this is the example. Ayan. So, dito po, grades will be based on the weighted row score of the learner's summative assessment based on 3 components. So, yung 3 component po, ng pagbibigay ng grade is written works or WWN, performance tasks or PT, and the last one is quarterly assessment. Ayan. So, nakikita nyo po dyan. So, sa step and example. So, step, get total score for each component. So, ito po yung mga ginagawa nila para makita po or makuha yung tamang grades ng mga students. So, kailangan i-total yung score for each component. Yung work, written work. So, ipagpa-plus po natin lahat yan. So, for example nga po dyan, 145 po yung kuha niya out of 160. And then, yung performance task, i-compute din po natin. So, 100 out of 120. And then, sa quarterly assessment, so maybe out of 50, nakakuha po siya ng 40. Ayan. And then, convert to percent. Ayan. So, i-divide po natin yung 145 divided by 160. So, yung makukuha po natin doon is yun yung percentage. So, dyan po yung 90.63, 83.33 sa PT, and then sa quarterly assessment, 80%. Ayan. So, ngayon naman po, i-convert natin yung percent to weighted score. Ayan. So, dito naman po is yung score po. So, halimbawa sa WW. So, yun po yung grades niya. Okay. So, now this is the example naman po. So, core subject sa written work. So, andyan 30%, 40%, and 20%. Ayan. So, written performance task. So, may 50, 40, and 60 na nakukuha. Ayan. And then, quarterly assessment. So, lahat po ng total dapat dyan is total of 100%. So, for the mapping, individual grades are given. Ayan po. So, individual grades are given to each area. So, halimbawa po ng mga subject, music, art, PE, and health. Ayan po yung nilalaman ng MAPE. So, the quarterly grades for MAPE is average grade across for the four areas as follow. So, ito po yung kailangan natin sundan. So, kailangan po yung quarterly grades for music, arts, PE, and health. Yun, ipagpa-plus po natin lahat yon. And then, i-divide po natin siya into 4. Ayan. So, the final grades for each subject is then computed by getting the average of the 4 quarterly grades. And then, dito naman po is, pag na-compute na po natin yon, yung makukuha natin doon, yun po yung grades ng ating students kapag dinivide natin yung apat na area ng MAPE. And then, i-divide into 4. Ayan. So, here naman po, example po ng report card na ginagawa ng ating mga kaguruan. Ayan. So, limbawa po, ayan. So, subject area, Filipino, English, Mathematics, Science, Aralin, Panlipunan, Edukasyon sa Pagpapakatao. Ayan po yung grades nila simula first grading, second, third, and fourth grading. And then, makikita po natin dyan yung final grades nila. And then, ayan po, yung general average is equal to 87. So, the learner's grade are the communicated to the parents and guardians. So, kapag nagkakaroon po tayo ng card day, ayan. So, yan po yung binibigay natin yung grade sa mga students natin. Sa mga parents, ayan, pinapaalam natin. So, andyan, dito din po papasok. Diba, meron din po yan sa grade cards natin, yung descriptor and grading system. Remarks, importante po na malaman yan ng ating mga students and mga parents. Ayan, so, dito po is yung nangunguna, syempre. Pag outstanding, ayan, yung grade niya po is 90 to 100. Yung average po. And then, very satisfactory from 85 to 89. Pass po yun. And then, satisfactory, 80 to 84, and then very satisfactory, so 85 to 79, so pass po yan. So, dito na last, did not meet expectations, so below 75, so it means 74 na po siya pa ba. So, failed na po yung student. Okay, so now let's move on. How should test result be communicated to different stakeholders? So, since grades serve as the important feedback about learners' level of performance of achievement, so teachers should communicate of test result to learners. Dapat pinapaalam po natin. Hindi lang sa students, ganun din sa kanila parents and to the other stakeholders. So, feedback on how well the learners performs on the test or any performance task has been proven to help them improve their learners. So, if test result are be served in mechanism to inform learners of what and where and how they should improve in their works and learning as a whole. So, there are three purpose of assessment in like to be achieved. So, first dyan is yung the rationale or purpose of testing. So, and the nature of test administered to learners should be cleared, explained. Dapat na-explain natin. This especially true for high stakes testing. So, such as those use of placement administration, grade level, promotion, graduation decision. Ayan. So, dito din po papasok yung IQ ng mga bata. Ayan. So, here is second. So, the meaning of test score should be explained. So, yung test score. So, kailangan yung mga rank, standard. So, standard score and na-explain po ng clearly. So, ayan. So, dapat yung rank ng mga students natin, yung percentage. So, tugma ba or tama ba yung pagkaka-arrange or pagkaka-total. And then finally, learners and parents should be made to understand the meaning of interpretation of their test score. Ayan. So, teacher have better grasp of the learner's capability in school. So, they are the best position to explain. Bakit, lalo na sa mga parents natin, kasi hindi lahat ng parents is approachable. So, yung iba nagigalit sila, agad-agad, di ba? So, kailangan as teacher, alam mo yung mga knowledge na meron yung students natin, kung saan yung part na pagkukulang nila, saan part sila nahihirapan, and saan yung strength ng mga bata, or pagkukulang nila. Ayan. To be able to check whether you learned the importance information of reading results. So, kailangan andito po yung graphical presentation. So, sa grading and report test result, so, andyan po yung limang sanya. So, kailangan yung purpose of reading and reporting test result. So, may purpose po yung pagbibigay natin ng grade sa mga students natin kasi hindi po i-report natin sa kanilang mga magulang. And then, method in marking or scoring test performance. So, ano ba yung mga method na kailangan natin ng mga rubrics? Just like that. And then, method in grading. So, type of test score. Ayan. So, ano po ba yung mga type na gagamitin natin sa mga test po nila. And guidelines in grading test or performance test. Ano ba yung dapat alam ng mga student? So, and then, strategies in communicating test result. Ayan. So, paano natin i-approach yung mga parents, yung mga students natin, so, pag nalaman nila yung score nila. Ayan. Okay. So, now let's move on to halimbawa ng reading on reporting test result. So, ayan. So, una po dyan is these are learning outcomes. So, and then, first topic, assessment method, method of scoring, type of test score. So, demonstrate understanding. So, and then sa course topic, and then paano dinify, paano niya yung bawat topic na tinakal natin with that particular time. And then, kung ano ba yung method ng assessment na ginamit niya? Written test ba? Performance test? Just like that. Or game-based, gano'n. And then, method of scoring. So, whether it is negative or positive marking. And then, pwedeng gagamit din dito ng holistic rubrics. Just like that. Multiple trait scoring sa apply. And then, sa test results. So, dito ang percentage yung pag-uha natin. And then, pwede ding mamili tayo pass or failed lang. Ayan. So, here now, let's move on in the development of reading results scheme. You need to follow the information. So, una dyan is purpose assessment. So, pag sinabi natin purpose of assessment, ito yung bakit ba or why is assessment being conducted? Para saan ba yung assessment? Anong purpose niya? It is for learners monitoring and improvement or being affirmative or demonstrating students' achievements or dun sa summative. Ayan. Second, these are learning outcomes for the topic or subject area. So, dito papasok. What are the learner's outcome expected from the learners for the unit or subject? Ano ba yung dapat na matutunan nila pagkatapos ng topic or subject area? And then, type of assessment. So, how will each outcomes be measured? So, paano natin mamamessure in what type of assessment? And then, criteria or grading criteria. So, what are the criteria that include to demonstrate achievement of stated desired learning outcomes? And then, scoring or grading method. So, how will be test? Or, paano natin mamimeasure or mabibigyan ng score yung performance test na binibigay natin? And then, 6, type of score. So, what type of score that are appropriate na ibigay natin sa mga students natin?